You ready to get going, mate?
Information regarding an emergency situation will soon be broadcast. Please stand by. Information regarding an emergency situation will soon be broadcast. Please stand by. Information regarding an emergency situation will soon be broadcast. Please stand by. This is an emergency notification regarding the potential abduction of a minor. A female named Martha Bidwell, aged 14, was last seen at the Tesco Superstore at 10:35 p.m. on security cameras, where she is seen exiting the store. Her phone was found broken on the floor on Harvey Street West. The authorities are on high alert at this time. Her family has been contacted, and they are currently with the police, who are attempting to determine the chain of events. If you have any information regarding this situation, may request that you contact the police via www.helpfind.gov.au, or using the telephone number, area code 000-312-5638. This is an emergency notification regarding the abduction a few days earlier. We have reports of two new abductees. Yesterday, a 12-year-old boy named Dylan Anderson went missing and was last spotted at the park near Shelter Woods. He was last spotted in a pale blue shirt and grey trousers. He is 5'1" tall, with black hair and blue eyes. His mother, his only surviving relative, is distraught and so far has not been able to cooperate with the authorities. His phone was also found destroyed, but it was found 3 miles north of the town, and police speculate that he was abducted, and the abductors found his phone while driving, and threw it out of the vehicle. The police now believe the Martha Bidwell was also taken north of the town, and have traveled north in an attempt to find anything that could lead to their location. Today, a 14-year-old male named Thomas Berbatov went missing this morning, while walking to school. He was wearing a black long-sleeve t-shirt and black trousers. He is 5'4" tall, with brown hair and eyes. He went missing on Windsor Road at approximately 8:12 a.m. No device was ever recovered. His parents have since said he was autistic, and was diagnosed with paranoid schizophrenia, and as such was very vulnerable and easy to manipulate. In the past 4 days, 3 minors have gone missing, with the assumption being that they have been abducted. In order to combat this, a curfew has been placed upon all minors at 5 p.m. If any minor is found outside unaccompanied, they will be taken to a local police station for their own safety. Even with parental supervision, minors are to go inside at 5 p.m. Failure to comply to these rules will incur a $100 fine. You are also advised to accompany your children to school, or ensure they travel to school in groups of no less than 5. These measures are to ensure their safety. Once a minor has been abducted, we cannot guarantee their safety. We do not know if they have been abducted with sexual intent or with intent to traffic. We urge you abide by these measures. Be aware that should the situation worsen, more intense measures may be introduced. This is an emergency message. The threat level for the town of Sundell is currently at watch and act, meaning an emergency is developing nearby, and you should act now to protect yourself and others. The police were informed of shots fired on Yawn Street East at 8:12 p.m. Police arrived to the scene to find the front door barely hanging on its hinges. Inside were four dead bodies, all with gunshot wounds to the head and body. After searching the house, police determined that in the house resided a family of five, with three adults and two children. The two children were not in the house. Next to the mother was a piece of paper saying they belong to us now. The fourth dead body not seen in any photos inside the house was confirmed to be a neighbor who came to investigate. The family were armed, with a gun found laying next to the father. No perceptions were found taken, and any damage caused to the house was likely due to a struggle. It is believed the intruders took only the children. Police are almost certain that the kidnappers of the three children a few days ago are linked with this case. It is expected that the abductors will attempt to break into more homes in order to take children. Considering that they took two children and went unnoticed, and that they took down an armed man with little to no struggle, it is believed that a highly armed group is responsible for this. You are advised to seek refuge in a basement or attic, or anywhere else that is well concealed. However, ensure this area is easy to exit, and will not leave you vulnerable if found. Take a weapon with you should they find you. A knife, baseball bat or gun will suffice. It would be wise if residents turned off all lights and made the house look as if nobody is home. Do not close your curtains, as it will seem as if everyone is asleep, which will invite the abductors. Do not use this method as a crutch, as if entire streets do this, they will enter buildings at random. You are still advised to hide in a well-concealed area with a weapon. SWAT teams have been called for, but due to the remoteness of the area surrounding Sundell, they will not arrive for approximately 45 minutes. Armed police have been dispatched, and are sweeping the streets at the moment. If you have any useful information, please dial the telephone number, area code 000-316-5638, or go to www.helpfind.gov.au. This is an emergency warning. We have confirmed reports of shots fired at the Sundell Hospital. At approximately 4:30 p.m., shots were fired outside the hospital. A white van pulled up outside the hospital, and multiple men exited and began shooting. They have made their way inside the building, and it is not known what they are doing. Police are certain this is linked with the events of last week. SWAT teams stationed within Sundell since last week have made their way to the building, and are just beginning to enter now. Their intentions are unknown as they have not been spotted, but it is likely they will attempt to round up children and exit the premises with them. SWAT helicopters have just landed on the hospital roof, and are beginning their descent through the building. We have reports that the attackers are stealing blood. They have been spotted stuffing packs of blood into duffel bags, and collecting blood of those they have shot in vials. They have begun their exit, and SWAT teams have not been able to maintain visual contact with them. Casualties, both of civilians are unknown, although deaths of both SWAT team members and civilians have been confirmed. We will update you when we have more information. This is an emergency warning. The current threat level is emergency, meaning you may be in danger and need to take action immediately, and the 10E delay puts your life at risk. We have confirmed reports of children walking from their homes randomly and ignoring their surroundings. They cannot be physically restrained and are in a trance state, with children simply walking towards their destination with a blank expression on their face. They are walking northbound, in the same direction as where the kidnappers who took three children traveled. Early estimates have shown the number of children leaving their homes in a trance to be around 3,200, but this is a rough estimate and could be higher or lower. If your child is in a trance state, you are to block all exits to your homes. There have been no reports of these children responding to anyone trying to block you, and nobody has been hurt trying to restrain them. You should block all doors and windows, and have as many family members attempt to pin them down. Police are currently at the front attempting to follow the children to determine the location of these kidnappers. Theories have been created as to how they achieved this widespread trance, but nobody has much knowledge regarding this, and certainly won't until the event is over. We are
What happened to that car?
Blown up. It pulled over into an alley and blown up. We don't know where those kids went now.
What the hell do we do now? Almost 4,000 kids have just strolled towards a bunch of pedophiles and we have no explanation.
Then we're gonna have to work one out. How many children were in the trance?
About 40% of all children in the area, give or take a few percent.
Good. Do we know what type of blood those people took from the hospital? If we find a type that matches that 40% estimate, then we can determine how this has occurred.
No, but hang on. There is a blood type near 40%. O positive is the most common blood type in the world, with a percentage of near 40%. These predators, they're controlling all the O positive children in the area.
What on earth? Correct?
Exterminate!